Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to thank every one of you to that have taken time from their busy schedule to be here today. We'll just be looking through what is the power of drones in survey industry and how does it go around. Drones have been around for quite some time. They have been used in multiple use cases. You have surveillance and security. You have had aerial filming. You have cinematography. And now they have come on to survey as well. They provide an invaluable help, cost savings, and a wide variety of views that are inaccessible and otherwise difficult and tough to navigate terrains. Surveying not only complements your existing terrestrial instruments, but also gives you a third world perspective, a third person perspective to say of the location. You not just have graphical data, but you now have visual data. You can run visual analytics on them. Surveying itself has come a long way. You have started with total station works. You had laser surveys, you had GPS, then your DGPS. Now you have come to drone surveys, especially global positioning systems that have created a greater interest in GIS. They provide wide variety of land related services like identifying property boundaries, subdividing land, placement of buildings, also produce topographic maps, hydrographic maps to analyze stressed assets. Drones provide a lot of benefits towards the survey industry, coming from something like disruption you may have. In some cases, drones need not be at the location. They can be operated remotely. You get high quality, high resolution images, which can be transmitted, shared, printed, or turned into maps. They give you heat maps. They give you topographical maps. These provide you further information that traditional surveys don't. There's barely any risk involved for the operator. As I said, it's all remotely controlled. You did not have to be there on the field. You need not have to go through the hurdles that regular traditional survey methods do. Aerial survey is predominantly can be split into three identical or three completely specific programs. One is your aerial data capture, which is where your drone comes into picture. You have data processing. We have so many good companies that have come up recently who has been there for in the long run for data processing. And then you have visualization and analytics, which I believe is the most key factor in surveys. All these together combine harmoniously create faster, safer, and cheaper operations for everyone working in it. The possibility of shortening a survey process, which used to take weeks, to now that it takes just days, has started to show the business bottom line for every company. And now that you are getting a much benefit out of it, everyone wants to do it. The process flow is quite simple. You just mark out your area, what has to be done. The drone flies autonomously, captures images. These images are then processed into your data processing softwares, uploaded to cloud if you want to share it with someone. And then these data, the visualization or the analytics, can be consumed, which is the most important factor in considering the outcome. Data capture, drones can do some part of it, whereas you still need traditional systems, something like your street data, which can only be got by traditional ways. Drones can do it, but drones do have some limitations. You have building data and vegetation data. All these interlaid on top of each other give you a very good integrated data set that can be used. Coming towards data processing, you have multiple softwares that are available in the market. You have Drone Deploy, Propeller, Pix4D. Depending on what your use case is, depending on what kind of outputs you want, depending on where you are doing it, the companies have to choose based on their scalability and growth and what they want to do with it. Analytics is the most important factor in this, because getting a data is not sufficient enough. If you cannot analyze, you cannot visualize the data. In this case, you might have an agriculture data set, you might have the health of a crop, or you might have an industrial data set which gives you damages or a health of an industry in general. But visualization is a key factor that makes a drone data stand out from any other traditional survey technique. Live progress monitoring. This has been brought up quite a number of times, which is an advantage of drones. Monitoring of construction sites, live monitoring of managements, your project management, maybe mine or any such other activity. Drones accelerate the process, facilitate quality inspections, assess problems, and give you a picture of the alternatives. They do this while reducing the labor burden and enabling more efficient allocation of personnel. There are n number of use cases. You are limited by your imagination where you want to use it. You have land surveying, asset management, construction monitoring, urban planning. You have mining and earthworks, archaeological survey, agricultural survey, pipeline monitoring, gas transmission line monitoring, among others. There's a huge business value when we come to a drone survey versus a traditional survey. It reduces your time from 2 to 3 weeks right unto 1 to 4 days. A survey that would regularly take close to around a day just to reach the place, 2 weeks to run the total station work. Today does it within 1 or 2 days, the whole data set is being captured. The processing that used to take 2 to 3 weeks now takes just 1 or 2 days, and that brings your time down by 6 times. It also gives you a significant cost reduction. A total station survey that would require 3 to 4 people to be on the field for 4 weeks is cut down to one person being on field for less than 2 days. And then that gives you at least a 40% cost reduction in your from your traditional survey methods. Coming to market analysis of what's the future, what's the demand in the survey industry today? With all the drone applications, you can see survey and aerial mapping has almost 37% of market share today. Not very far is industrial inspection and infrastructure, which is also an extension of survey and mapping. Today, the drone survey and analytics market was valued at almost around $40 billion. And it's a projected growth of a compounded annual growth rate of almost around 28.1% up to 2025. That creates a lot of opportunities for new businesses, a lot of opportunities for construction industries, or even survey industries that want to come up today. Thank you.